Hey everyone, breakfast vlog for Saturday the 13th of October. I had to search in my brain there, 2018. Wow, sorry I missed yesterday. Life intrudes. Yesterday was firefighting day, I believe, and anyway it was. And we did a dog and pony show at the school for the kids, for the young kids, kindergarten, one, two, and three maybe, I can't remember exactly, you know, but those are the kids that, they get scared easy, and so you gotta make them understand that the firefighter who's dressed, looks like he's dressed from some kind of horror movie, is not there to kill you, he's there to save you, so. You know how kids are, right? They're new, they're learning. It's our responsibility as sane adults to hopefully teach them right. But a beautiful day here in Nicas, Saturday. I just went to the market. It's just gorgeous. It's absolutely gorgeous today. One cloud in the sky that I can see. I've got a lot of projects. I've got some ladies that I have to help today. You know, fence fixing, stair fixing, little Joe jobs just to keep me busy, and that occupies a lot of my time, and I've noticed that my hiking and that has diminished a lot as my responsibilities in this town increase, firefighting, stuff like that, you know, and I'm starting to do more and more because I want to be involved in my community, right? For me, that's what keeps me sane. That's what I need to do in order, and these are things that I've talked about, mental health and such, things that you identify for yourself that you have to do in order to preserve your own well-being. It's like anything else. For me, I go to the dentist once a year so that I know that I don't have dental problems, because I don't want to have abscessed teeth later, because I've had them. I've had roots go bad and ignored it until the pain was just so great that, so anyway, you know what I'm talking about. So for me, doing stuff in town is very important, but that's not what I want to talk about. Just a little bit of what was going on yesterday. Love doing dog and pony shows for the kids. I used to love doing them in the military, you know, you just play with all your toys. You basically play with all your toys and you play with the kids. It's fun. If for those of you who've had kids, and I miss my kids, I mean, they're grown adults now. They're 26 and 25, so they're not kids anymore and they're not mine. I had the honor of raising two human individuals and helping them to make their way in the world, but they're not mine. They don't belong to me. I was honored. It's like the cat doesn't belong to me. I've been chosen to bring it into the world or make its life okay. Whatever. So, anyway. So, I miss having the young kids around. You know, empty nest stuff. But anyway, that's not what I want to talk about today. Wow, okay. Hurricane Michael. A couple other things I wanted to talk about as well. But we'll just quickly touch on Hurricane Michael. I was watching videos yesterday, last night, let's say about an hour's worth of drone videos, helicopter videos of Mexico Beach and all along the Panhandle. And I used to live down there when I was going to school in Eglin. I think we were in Niceville, Valparaiso. Is that right? Niceville, Valparaiso. We used to go to Fort Walton Beach all the time. So when I saw yesterday, I was... You know when you're watching something and you feel this coldness all over you, you're like, it's surreal and you're getting the shivers and you're like, you're feeling really bad for those people? Because I'm talking like, I'm like, well, there's a house that's in the middle of the road. And that's not supposed to be there. And, well, there's all the footprints for the houses. Where are the houses? I mean, there's nothing. You know, you'd think you'd see like the house like... on in itself. No, you just see the little square and it's been brushed clean, like as if somebody came over it with a scrub pad. The wind did that job, you know, at 155 to 175 gusting. Well, that's sandpaper. That's going to take everything off the planet. I mean, you know, you get up a little bit more and that's it. The only thing I can say about, and I'm not giggling and laughing at what's going on down there, is that when I was watching the videos of the helicopters and the drones flying around, I'm like, oh, I want to find the guy who built that house. You know, you're going around and say, okay, whoever the contractor did these three houses, because everything else is decimated around it, And then you go and there's three houses that are perfectly standing. It doesn't even look like nothing happened. But they're still standing. So I was like, wow, you know, like you find that guy. But what absolute, utter, horrific devastation, as if a bomb went off, like, you know, Holocaust stuff, you know, nuclear war, whatever. It was just, I was just looking at it, you going, the helicopter was like a 10-minute video, and Buddy was booking along the whole beach. And I was like, holy macaroni, you know, I hope everybody did seed or yield or whatever to the warnings and get the out of Dodge. Because that was nasty. Like, that was brutally nasty. So, that whole area is absolutely destroyed. I don't know how far inland it goes. From what I gather, it, you know, went all the way up into the Carolinas, and, you know, a couple people that I know down there, I haven't seen videos from them, so I don't know if anything's going on with their abodes. So hopefully they're doing okay, but, you know, Mother Nature, don't, you know, was it, it's a commercial, don't mess with Mother Nature. You know, and that's the truth, but prayers go out to those people. Hopefully, like, the whole area, like the roads, the bridges, the houses, the parks, the infrastructure, everything is destroyed. The whole place needs to be rebuilt. To some, like, only go watch the videos. It's tragic. I'll put the drone video of one that I found was the most well, sad, I guess, for lack of a better term. I mean, I thought, oh, well, I'll build a house out of concrete. And then I go and the drone goes over to a concrete pile of concrete blocks that was a house. And I'm like, oh, okay, I guess that's not going to work. Anyway, wow, wow, wow. And the way my heart feels and the way I believe in, and I'm of a mind that we're transitioning in our Milky Way galaxy, and things are only going to get more worse. More worse? Worser? More worse. More, anyway, more heinous. So, you know, as we move along and whatever, you know, I don't believe in the AGW, but I know something's changing. Anyway, that's enough about Hurricane Michael. I hope everybody took precautions. Second topic, real quick. Blue wave, red wave. Okay, we've got a real, like, I've been watching the Kanye back and forth, and I did the video about, I can't remember what it was, the last one on Thursday. I did two videos on Thursday, and I forgot. I was talking, sort of hitting on the blue wave, red wave type stuff, and I don't think I spoke about Kanye West, but, and I'm not going to talk about what he said or whatever like that. I'm talking about the emotional reaction that I see happening right now on both sides. Okay, once again, I'll reiterate, there's a complete divide, there's an absolute divide. November, I'm very worried for November. People are on such the ragged edge right now, and the manipulation in the media is so over the top that no matter what happens in November, there's going to be a reaction by some people. And, you know, I'm predicting a red wave. That's my prediction. Now, am I right? Am I wrong? Is it by design that the blue wave will come so that we'll decimate the red and, you know, the impeachment and all that stuff and, you know what I mean? Or the red wave comes and then the blues just, because if I look at it, the amount of violence that's out there right now is over the top too. Like, we've got people actually inciting violence, and for whatever reason, nobody's reacting to it. You know, we see a couple things where people step back and let the civilians sort it out. But mark my words, once it gets out of hand and you start intruding and life starts intruding on those who don't want to play the game, that's when things will change. And you talk about martial law or partial, curfews and stuff like that. Like, I've been listening to the older population and hearing what they will invite martial law so that they can go to Walmart, so they can go to bingo, so they can go to golf. these are the these people, like this boomer generation, are the ones with the most money, and they're the ones, they're the most of them around. So, and they vote too, right? So, you gotta look at it. So, red wave, blue wave, November frightens me. See what happens. The emotion's ready, everything's primed, everything's ready. So keep your wits about you. Keep your wits about you. And that's all I can say about that. I mean, just look at the narrative. Watch what's going on. Watch what's being said. You don't have to listen to the left or the right. Watch the reaction by the populace. That's what you need to look at. Though your neighbors, everybody around you, that's the important part. I mean, you know what the authorities are going to do. You know, so, and speaking of that, and I'll just segue into my next and last topic. We have a beautiful little town here, okay? Beautiful little town here in the cusp. We've got really good RCMP members. I know them all personally. You know, we've broken bread at, you know, barbecues or whatever, and I know this one's got children, and he's got a new family, and this guy's young, and this guy's older, and she's, you know, she's the corporal, and she's in charge, or whatever. So I know that kind of stuff, and a good bunch of people. And they go around here and they keep everything nice. But they don't waste their time burning you because you just happened to roll into a stop sign or you forgot to put your seatbelt on. But what we've got today is we've got out-of-towners who come to our town to give out tickets of guys rolling through stop signs. So what they're doing is they're disrespecting our police officers who work in this community and make them look bad and get everybody's hackles up. You're not serving and protecting. You're enforcing ordinances. Ordnance is bombs. Ordinances, if I'm using those two words. Yeah, ordnance is explosive. Ordinance is a rule. So that's what they're Leos. They're not serving and protecting. They're not getting cats out of trees. They're not helping the seniors with their groceries. They're slave enforcement officers, just keeping the thumb on top of you and disrespecting our members here and coming up here from three towns over so that they can give out parking tickets or speeding, you know, moving violations. Redonkulous tickets, tickets that don't do anything, you know, like I had said about in the speeding. Raising the fines, all it means is the rich don't care, like, you know, the ones who have so much money that they can pay speeding tickets. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You know what I mean. You're good, intelligent people on YouTube. I don't need to explain this to you, but it's just, you know, when we try and identify what the problem is or why you're pissed off that day, well, it's not because, you know, there was three people in the lineup at the grocery store in front of you and they were a little slow or whatever. It's the dum-dum who's giving out tickets for nothing. Go out in the corners where they have all the accidents, with all the major, you know, we see all the crosses and everything on the side of the road. You know, you probably get that in America too, you know, you got crosses where the cars have always seemed to go off the road at the same time because it's a bad corner, you know, so, you know, there'll be a memorial set up there. Get the people that are going to possibly cause an accident and kill themselves. All you're doing is pissing people off at the stop sign. You're not saving lives. You're not helping out, you know. I mean, really, is it all by design? Well, of course it is. I mean, let's be real. It's ridiculous, though. Really, really disrespecting of our officers here in town for these guys, and they should know better. They should know better to come and, in the jurisdiction of another, but we're highway patrol, we do whatever we want. No, you can't. And if I was an RCMP member, I'd be looking for these guys today, and I'd be saying, what are you doing? What are you doing in my town? What are you doing here? You know, if we had the sheriff of mashed potatoes like you guys have down in America, you know, he could roll up and say, what's going on today? Where are you from? You're harassing my citizens? You're harassing my people that are going to get pissed off at me because you're being a dick? That's what it's all about. Don't do that. Don't do that. Please don't do that. That's not kosher. Not at all. Not one scrap. Not one bit. But, somebody had asked me, and this will be the last thing, and I'll shut up now because I'm rambling and cooking, and I got to get some projects done today. Somebody asked me about, there's been a change in our knife laws in Canada again. Now, I've just read up on it last night, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to our members before I make a video, and I'm going to get the skinny from them. I've got a whole bunch of different collections, you know, spider coats, flip knives, belt knives, tool knives. You've seen, probably all seen my belt knife video from way, way back when I was cutting a can with my knife, but I gotta go find out what's the skinny, pardon me, coffee burp, and then I'll make a video about the knives, so that'll be coming, but I have to go, and I want to get it right from the horse's mouth. I'll take notes. He won't be on video, because that's not the way it works. I'll get notes, and then you'll just have to trust what I'm telling you, and then you just go to the law and find out what's going on. But from what I gather, it has a lot to do with intent. And you know, if you've got a belt knife at a bar, you don't need a belt knife at a bar. If you had a belt knife when you're walking around your yard, yeah, that's a different story. But anyway, I'm going to go find out about all that stuff, about the knives, you know, carrying knives. You know, you can, one small thing, you can carry a sword cane. I just saw that. You can actually carry, you know, where you pull the out of the cane and it's a sword. Now, okay, I'm just what I read last night, so I got to check more, and I'm going to ask the members, because that seems a little odd that you can walk around with a sword. But then again, I think that's cool. I think we should all walk around with swords. That would be cool. Yeah, a big sword, you know, big claymore sitting off the side of your belt or something. I mean, you know, a nice 20-pound sword. Okay, I'm rambling. Peace to you and yours. Hope you're having a great day, and I hope to see you on the flip side.